me so basic. Well, you the op and your bros hating. All of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing.
Now, this great venue has hosted some memorable playoff games over the years, and these Bear fans are hoping to make some new memories today at Soldier Field in Chicago. Coming up, it's the final game of Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a good NFC matchup in store between the Washington football team. And whistle blown, a timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And the Chicago Bears. Winner go home is the mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC wild card game. Taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too. And this is Ty Johnson. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard after the 36.
1 yard gain.
Second and 9 now. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And a 5 yard gain gets him to the 42.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
That's complete to Mooney. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
Chicago Bears.
They'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked by Kendall Fuller. And he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They've been a come-from-behind team all year. They'll need to do it again as they trail early in this wild card game. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And that's going to be incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And his throw here is incomplete. Darnell Mooney, the target there. And it's third down.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. He'll drop to throw. The screen pass here to Cohen. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 14 yards into Chicago first down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And this is incomplete.
Well, certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. Quick hitter here, it's complete. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's third and 10.
No gain on the play. It's third and 10.
They'll look to throw again. He'll drop this one down to Cohen. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Mark that down as a pickup of 13, and the Bears have the first.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Back to throw again. Screen play, Johnson. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And all the way down to the 33-yard line. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
That was a beautifully executed screen pass. Let the rushers get upfield. The blocking forms in front. Lofted it to the runner. And now, not only does he have open space in front of him, he's got an escort as well, and they pick up big yardage.
He'll take a shot for the end zone. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
I usually hesitate when I say a guy's got world-class speed, but this guy might. So let's fire the starter's pistol. Let's go. If you've got him, you've got to try and use him. A lot of anticipation with the ball in the air, but no, incomplete.
And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They'll run for the first time with Tariq Cohen. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. Great call to hand that one off. And his running back did the rest.
Someone read their keys correctly. And on the defensive side of the ball, they certainly did not, because they really essentially were just going to swarm the quarterback. They kind of guessed themselves out of the play. And guess who benefited? The guy with the football.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
Get on out of here. I just gotta say, like I run up in the backfield.
stopped immediately there. The tackle by Robert Quinn.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
At the 21-yard line.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. They run the option on second down. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
Pass on second down. It muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. Snap coming at one. Now Wentz. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It's a gain of nine, but it's also going to mean a punt here on their opening drive. They'll try and run the option. They get this out quickly to the left side. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Previous run, good for nine. Here's second and a yard. Here's a quick throw out wide. It's McLaurin. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now third and three. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Akeem Hicks in there to get him for a loss of three, and it will be fourth down. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through, and it's 3-0 Washington. To chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
Over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Back to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Reuben Foster picks it, and they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
At the 47-yard line.
Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now an option play on second down. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming. Working from the gun, Wentz. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Bringing up 3rd and 12.
The Bears on third down. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd down and 12. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card round. They told us the wild card could be that defensive pressure. They showed it there.
And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it here. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. So that is 3 interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest, we're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
They'll start with the option. He's going to get this inside the 30. It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down.
A gain of 14. First down, Washington.
Now Wentz. This is brought in by Gibson. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three.
Complete to Antonio Gibson.
2 minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs.
At the 23-yard line.
Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown of what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up. He certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Rosas' kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more.
First and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And looking at this situation, Charles, you got more than a minute. You've got all three timeouts. Probably no need to play this safe.
So what you're saying is that we're doing a little bit of a mind meld here, aren't we? Because I'm thinking along the same lines as you. This amount of time, don't be compelled to play it too safe. This is a chance to get points on the board. Press it a little bit.
Yeah, especially since a touchdown here gets you the lead.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
So now they'll come up on 2nd and 10, once again from the 28. Out of the gun, running with Cohen. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9.
Ball carrier. He was taken down by Rubin.
They'll try to run for it with Cohen. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Rubin Foster picks it. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
You're trailing, you're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. Throwing his Wentz to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
Hands it off out of the gun. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12.
Washington.
Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Running back, it's complete. And here he'll get it down to the seven. That'll bring up fourth down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. Rosa's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Eddie Pinheiro to kick off for Chicago.
One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
20-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material.
First down, Washington.
Right back to it on the first down. And not much doing. He'll get this only up to about the 36. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
A gain of a yard. Brings up second and 9.
On play action, Wentz. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A gain of 32 that time.
And the Washington first down.
Try the right side here. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
A gain of 14. First down, Washington.
Down close to the 10-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Time of the play clock almost up. Ron Rivera's going to call a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. from the shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And once again, he's going to be stopped up behind the line. Second straight play. Shades of the 85 Bear defense a little bit. Shotgun now for Wentz. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown.
Terry McLaurin.
From 13 yards out. And Washington is able to stretch their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
They'll try and run it here. And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good.
You know, sometimes the guy on the defensive side of the ball, he just has a good feeling or a good read, and he unleashes defense on that one. Boy, they stopped him in a big way.
Yeah, I hate to be cliche, but sometimes we overanalyze. They just have more want. Looked like they had more want right there.
More want and more people to the ball.
Tre'Mon Smith on the return. The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down.
First and 10 at the 40.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And he completes it to Cohen. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 9-yard line. 29-yard line. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. The man is Kmet, the tight end. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Second and six. At the 20.
Gets this to his running back, Tariq Cohen. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of five or six.
That's a gain of five. Brings up.
They'll look to throw for it on third and one. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues down.
And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Bears cut into that lead.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense, but when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. This taken in about 4 yards deep. point. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
It's a gain of 3. First down, Washington.
They fake the give. Now wins. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And this one is incomplete.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get, taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Muster a yard here to the 38. Washington on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 9.
And it's 3rd down.
To throw is Wentz. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48, and this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call.
And the Washington pressure gets to him. He will go down. Chase Young. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. On second down, Johnson. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a 3rd down. Well executed there on 2nd down, so do you go back to the air on 3rd?
Well, that's a possibility, but now you've opened up things to where you showed that you would run the ball in long-distance situation. You might come back again because I doubt they believe you'll do it a 2nd time.
He gets it left side to Johnson. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. First down for the Bears, a gain of 15.
And that's a much-needed first down right there. Look, they're down by 8. So logic says they don't have to get a touchdown out of this drive. But the way things are going, I don't know if I'd put it in the hands of my defense here. You might not get the ball back at all. So if a 4th down situation comes up, I'm thinking hard about going for it right here and right now.
They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. The screen pass here to Cohen. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds, right around the 7. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
To throw again. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Darnell Mooney there to make the grab. And now the Bears are within a 2-point conversion of tying up the game. And in the red zone, I guess this is why you have a guy like that on your roster.
Without a doubt, if you have him, you use him because he's a guy who's going to win just about every time. I don't care what the coverage is.
And they don't get it. They tried for the 2-point conversion there, but unsuccessful.
Washington 22, Bears 20. Eddie Pinheiro, the kickoff.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Out there, set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And this, a very important drive, leading in the fourth quarter of this wild card game. But this one far from over as they start out here first down.
It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. That catch good for only a couple.
On the pickup, it's second and eight at the 26-yard line.
To throw again on second down. Wentz.
And he'll get this to Antonio Gibson complete.
And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and nine. Wentz to throw, escaping the pressure right. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and this is picked up by the Bears, and he'll bring it back to about the 5-yard line.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. Give him four on the carry there, and second and goal.
Second and goal.
They'll run it with Johnson, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Ty Johnson, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Bears have retaken the lead. And the lead is up to five.
Good. Makes the score Bears 27, Washington.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Out there, set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a crucial, crucial drive, first and 10. This to McLaurin out on the left side.
Complete to Terry McLaurin. 10 yards on the pickup. It's second.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. Throwing now is Wentz. It's caught on the right side. It's Smith. 7 yards there at a first down.
Complete to number 18. A gain of seven. And the Washington first down.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Wentz now on first down. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41.
On play action, it's Wentz. Smith catches left side. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down, got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understanding of where they are in the field?
Inside give,
and they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. Back to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third.
Crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
When you talk about making winning plays, that is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that, because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead, they found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts, as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. Again, it's Johnson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout, as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. They go to Johnson again. He's got daylight. The 40, 20, 10, and he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
But I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
Extra point splits the uprights, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. And this carries into the end zone, and he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
Their own 25-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z, and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Give him 28 yards on that one, and it'll move the chains.